This is your pastor, Tom Cully. By now, you have probably heard that the president is now asking the governors to open up churches this weekend. And if the governors fail to open the churches, then he is going to override the governors and have churches open. First place, let me just share with you that there is a separation between church and state. And no governor or president can make you go to church. That is something that you can do if you so desire. So I just want to just share with you all and put your mind at ease right now. Our church is not going to reopen until it is completely safe for us to do so. Matter of fact, let me just say that again. Our church is already open. The church is really the people. And every Sunday, we're conducting a worship service where you can worship your God. Not only worship, you can even study, because we have a Sunday school program going where you can study the Word of God. So you are going to church right now. What we're talking about is a building. And the president is now saying that those buildings can be opened. But we're not going to open our building until it's safe to do so. First place, it's irresponsible for a president or a governor or for anybody in official position, authority in this state, to open or give orders to open something like a church on a Friday. If the church is going to open, it has to prepare to be opened. These churches, these buildings have been closed for 3 months. The water might not be working in the church properly. There might be rodents in the church these 3 months that have not been taken care of. The church building itself might not be ready. There might be germs in the church that have to be taken care of. You might have to go in and work on the germs and clean the church before people can come in. Secondly, before you can occupy a building again as a church, you have to talk to the members, prepare them. Will be wearing masks or don't you wear a mask? Will we be sitting 6 feet apart or won't we be sitting 6 feet apart? Will there be a choir or won't there be a choir? Because the CDC has already figured out that singing, you spread more germs singing than talking. So you have to work out those situations. Where will the preacher be? Where will the praise team be? Who will be the deacons? How will they interface with the people? How will the ushers interface? What are the other ministries that's going on in church? How are you going to do those? There are so many things that have to be considered before you can go back into a building as a church. And for a president to make such a statement on a Friday, because I'm quite sure there will be evangelical churches and probably some non-evangelical churches will open their doors on Sunday and people will go into the building. And 2 weeks from now, we will have a spike in the number of people who have been contacted with this coronavirus. The Lord did not give us a spirit of fear, but He gave us a spirit of love, power, and a sound mind. And that sound mind says that we are not to do things that would endanger each other. None of us know who has what. That's the reason why we wear masks, so that my mask can protect you. You wear a mask so that it can protect me. We are concerned about each other's. No good shepherd would ever lead his flock or her flock into an area that was infested with wolves. A good shepherd is there to protect his or her flock. So, trying to be a good shepherd, I am not going to order, not suggest, not encourage anybody to come back into the building until it is safe to do so. And you might say, well, Pastor, what do you mean by safe? Well, use your common sense. When you feel that you are safe enough to go to a movie theater, when you feel that you are safe enough to get on an airplane, when you feel safe enough to go to take your children to school and let them stay in school, when you feel you are safe enough to go around your relatives, go into a hospital, go into a nursing home, when you feel safe enough to do those things, then you will know what safe is. We are not going to endanger any of our members in any way. Now, some might take offense to what I'm saying. Some might disagree with what I'm saying. But what I'm saying, I hope you will receive in the love and in the manner in which it is given. It is given out of nothing more than love. We have a church. The church meets every Sunday. And for those of you who do not have Wi-Fi access to Wi-Fi, or we now have arranged with the Township of Edison to put our church services on the television. Twice a week, that service will be there. Once we do the service on Sunday, it will then be recorded and up on their network on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, all the way up until the next Sunday. So even if you don't have Wi-Fi, you can now still go on television and not see Joel Osteen, not see any of those preachers. You can go on there and see your own pastor. You can see your own ministers, your own first lady, people who belong to the church, your church. You can witness them. You can have the same experience at your home, worshiping your Lord, because He is most certainly there. So we're inviting you now to, if you're in Edison and you do have Optimum as your cable service, you can follow us on Channel 15. If you are in Edison or any other township and you have Fios on your cable service, then you can follow us on channel 45. But most of you have access to a tablet or a computer, and you can follow us every Sunday at 11 o'clock at www.mpbclive.org. O-R-G. And every Sunday at 9:30, you can attend our Sunday school. Reverend Johnson is waiting and willing to send out the material, and she can invite you to come to a Zoom presentation where you can see the other classmates, or you can take your telephone and dial a number and you can hear what's going on. So I just want to just share with you all, I wanted this opportunity to just come before you so you can see me face to face, to let you know that regardless of what the president might say, we are not going to go back into the building until it's safe to do so. And I hope and pray that each and every one of you agree with that decision. We will be talking more about it later on. As we get closer and closer to some way of getting into the building, we will have a team set up to sit down and think through the different issues that we have to put in place. The way we would do the bulletins, the way we would do the choir, the way we would do the singing, and all of those kinds of things have to be worked out. So rest assured, we are not going to be forced to do something that we do not want to do. For we only abide by what God ordains us to do, and that is to go out, make disciples, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And when Jesus gave us that great commission, He did not specify that we have to do that inside a building. He said, go, and we're doing it every Sunday through electronic medium. So we pray that you understand what Pastor is saying, and we hope that you agree with what Pastor is saying. We most certainly do. So I ask you now to continue enjoying your evening. It's a blessed day. We had a beautiful day today, and I'm quite sure we have another beautiful day tomorrow. And surely I'm quite sure God will be with us. As I always tell you, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your path. Good evening. Have a great evening.